Hey, it's James Cebulski from EA Sports, and we are in Edmonton, where we got a party on White Ave after this one tonight. But first, the Oilers are ready to roll. And we are about set to drop the puck tonight. The Blues start with possession as we are now underway. Quick pass to Letty. Poked away by Nurse. The Blues gain control of the puck against the wall. Picked up along the boards by Thomas. Feeds it down low. Moves it quickly over to Buchnevich. Shot for score! And just like that, it's a 1-0 hockey game.
Well, it started like a freight train just steamrolling their opponent, James. I mean, they really dictated right from the onset of this game. That tells me one thing. They were prepared coming in. That's a beautiful finish, but I'm telling you, he's got to go over to his teammate and say thank you very much for that beautiful pass. I mean, it was placed perfectly on his stick. He didn't have much time to react, but he could collect it, and he found a way to put it home.
The Blues are on the board quickly in this one, and a nice start here the way that they've been moving the puck around.
Well, a really great start for them, James. It's all about getting everyone into the game, establishing some pressure, and finding a way to get on the board. They do just that. Now they've established a 1-0 lead. It's about holding it and pushing for more now.
Picked up along the wall by McDavid. Looking to make something happen along the boards. And down he goes as the puck goes free. Picked off. Kyrou's got it through the neutral zone. Keeps possession on the play. And he was locked in on that save as play continues. Here we go, one-man rush. And a stick in the lane ends that threat. Letty's the victim of a hook penalty coming up. The Blues played along the boards.
Oh, save on the play! Whoa! He's doing absolutely everything he can to keep his team in this game, James. Unbelievable save.
There's the whistle. Let's get the official decision.
Well, that's certainly not going to help the team. I mean, they're losing by one. They've got to find a way to get some momentum to get on the board. Now they find themselves killing a penalty.
Well, this gives us our first chance to take a look at the team's power play unit.
Well, first power play of the game, James. You want to start with possession and look to get shots to the net. It is the tone setter.
Oh, that's gotta hurt. What a play. Player goes down to the ice. There's the referee's hand in the air. Looks like we got a tripping penalty on the way. The goaltender is quickly off to his bench to get the extra attack around. And that slides right out to center ice. Nice play shorthanded as they get control of the puck. Takes the feed at center and moves up ahead. Takes the puck into the corner of the offensive end. Made that stop. The Oilers have the puck in the corner. And the officials will pass the sentence here. The Blues are getting 2 minutes for tripping. As we get set for the face-off, a chance to see both teams in a little four-on-four action here.
Four-on-four, you want to utilize north, south, east, west, and capitalize on the speed with the extra ice available. You can bet your coaching staff is going to put some pretty quick players out there.
Shen's got it along the wing.
He scores!
Deflate or inflate, and that's an inflator. When you get a shorthanded goal, you know that you switch the momentum.
Thomas is ready for the face-off as they'll continue to kill off this penalty. Oh, and he takes possession of the puck from off the wing with the centers all locked up there off the draw. Scores! On the minute, Krejci put one home!
And this is exactly why he spends so much time in practice working on specialty teams, James. You can see that good movement to open up lanes, just disrupt the box there, and they're able to cash it in. It takes hard work in the intangibles to get available for a one-timer in that low slot area. You know it's going to be a grind if you have to fight for your space. He does a great job of it and buries it home.
Edmonton's got to be feeling good after getting that one, Cheryl.
Well, they're certainly feeling good about themselves now, James. The body language has changed. They're on their toes. The confidence has lifted. Some much-needed offense to get them within one.
Thomas has won the draw here in the neutral zone. Great use of the body to knock him off the puck. Slip feed. Picked off by Buchnevich. Moves it to Lenny. Inside the defensive zone, moving the puck. Gives it right back. Handles the puck. Edmonton's looking to break out of their own end. And he takes the pass. Here's a shot, and he keeps that one out. Handles the bank pass along the boards. There's the whistle. Let's get the call from the officials.
Such a tough penalty to take when the game's within reach. They're looking for the equalizer, and now they find themselves shorthanded.
St. Louis is set to go back to work on the power play.
They haven't scored yet in the game on the power play, but no need to get frustrated. They all bring a different skill set. It's the reason why they're out there.
Here's a short pass to Verona. And we get a whistle as the goaltender decides to hang on to this one. Still some precious time left on this power play as they get set to drop the puck. Back underway as he wins the draw inside the offensive zone. Quick feed to Kulak. Intercepted at center by Hayes. Edmonton's penalty killers get a hold of it. Quick pass to Verona. The Blues played along the wing. Just a little too much contact and couldn't hang on to the puck. The Oilers have played from the defensive zone. Moves it quickly over to Blaze. Tremendous stop by Skinner.
Blaze's last play was a tough one, James. He loses his balance, which makes it difficult for him to corral the puck and get it off with precision, but he makes the play.
Shot! Scores! And they capitalize with the extra player on the ice, and it's a power play goal.
While using the advantage of having extra ice available to them, James, that's why their most skilled players are on the ice. That one's executed to perfection.
Here in the late goings of the period, St. Louis continues to lead by a pair of goals. Edmonton's won the faceoff at center. And now it's grabbed by Draisaitl. Scooped up along the wall by Ekholm. The Oilers played along the wing. Scores! Ryan Nugent Hopkins!
Gotta give some credit to the shooter here, James, for finding the hole, and that hole is low glove side. I think that the goaltender, he wants this one back.
The Blues are holding down the lead here late in this first period. They have looked really good offensively so far. And off the draw, they take the puck. Moves around along the half wall. Quick shot, and makes the save. Slides it across to Cece. Edmonton's going on the attack as they gain the zone. Clock ticking down here inside the first period. Lays the body into that play. CeCe's got control of it now behind the cage. Takes the feed at the point. And he hangs on just as time runs out. There's the buzzer. Fans seem to enjoy that first 20 minutes. We'll get to the second period right after both teams get a chance to catch their breath. Stick around. The middle stanza is about to go. The official's ready to drop the puck. Batteries are charged up, and here we go with period number two. Let's see what the officials are calling. The Oilers are off to the box. Interference the call.
I love the 1-3-1 set on the power play unit they used earlier. Listen, they had success, they scored, but there's so many variations off of it. I love the bumper position that can act as a decoy, allow the puck to get through to create those seams and open up those shot attack lanes.
Thomas in the corner now. Score! There it is on the power play!
Their power play has been really efficient tonight, James, and they're really gaining momentum off of it. And often when you're drawing this many penalties, teams start to play different against you.
The Blues are enjoying things in twos. Here in period number two, they've gone up by two, Cheryl.
There's been a lot of twos, James, and they'd love to get another couple goals to really pad the stats and increase their lead. But right now, it's about habits, not giving their opponent any life in this game.
Edmonton's got it along the wall. Puck picked up by Kane. Looks to pass it to Kyrou. Takes a spill onto the ice and loses the puck. Great pass from the left wing up the middle now. And he's ridden off the puck. Here's a chance to the middle. And that doesn't connect. They've got an on man rush. Cut it to the net. Denied on the play. Oh, wow. And it's a quick pass to Kapanen. From center, they get into the attacking area. And the save. The Oilers scoop it up along the boards. With possession along the wall. Toss into the paint. Sensational stop by Bennington.
Oh, save it! Oh, my goodness, what a stop!
That's unbelievable, James. I have no idea how he got to that puck. It's some gymnastics at its finest.
Scores! The Oilers light the lamp!
To find this puck on his backhand, James. He's running out of real estate, but he was able to put it through and find the netting.
The Oilers have come to life here in the second. Cheryl, what's your assessment now?
Well, I like the way they've played. They've had a ton of possession. They're just sticking with the game plan, and they get rewarded with that goal.
Puck is dropped, and we are back on the way. Delayed penalty coming up here. Well, look at this, Cheryl. Here we go. The parade is officially underway.
It certainly is. And everyone in the building, you can hear the crowd just jeering with their frustration, including everyone on the bench, completely deflated right now.
A non-stop procession with a penalty box for the home team. St. Louis is ready to go back to work on special teams.
Gotta love when it feels easy, James. When the power play is working, the puck is moving, there's motion, everything seems directed at the net.
Hammers a shot off a stick. And that's picked away by play. Oh, that's a huge stop by Skinner. Puck is cleared out of the defensive zone. Dishes it to Verana. The Blues are on the attack. Moves it to play. Shot! A stop by the goaltender. Feeds the puck over to Nugent Hopkins. The Oilers take it along the wall. The Blues gain possession. The Oilers gonna work on offense. Let's get the call.
Well, the PKers are getting a ton of ice time, but guess what? Your offensive players are not, so you can't generate and produce. They gotta figure out a way to stay out of the box. So much ice available, you can't overthink it, but you have to have the ability to move the puck. Know which side you want to be on, onside, offside for the one-timer, but you have to make the drive to the net.
Center in front, the shot! Toss up the puck after that hit. Dreisaitl's going to join the penalty kill here as they remain shorthanded. The Oilers will play it against the boards. Edmonton's got the puck in the corner. And a nice takeaway in the defensive end by Saad. Breakaway! Denied on the breakaway! Oh, he came up clutch there!
Well, he really did. Anytime that you're one-on-one, you gotta beat the shooter, and that's exactly what he does.
Picked off by Saad.
The Blues are doing a great job of anticipating the play, and that's why the puck is on their stick. They're intercepting pucks all game long. They've got to make good on them. They've got to transfer.
Oh, what a save! He stopped it! Wow!
Oh, that's an intangible effort that you can't teach, James. That's all about desperation and the will to stop that puck.
Good stand-up hit. The Oilers will play it from the corner. Pass back to the point. Drives it to the crease. St. Louis has possession of it now.
Binnington's been so impressive, in particular in that last sequence, James, and he's out of gas. Didn't prevent him from making that save, but now he's going to get some much-needed rest as that puck heads out of the zone.
Oh, and he just puts it wide of the net.
Sometimes players get into those scoring areas, and they try and get a little too cute, and that's a result right there, not hitting the net.
And he loses control of the puck. Nice feed from the right wing. Edmonton's on the attack. The Blues with time for one last rush. Faulks lugging the puck. And he connects with the long bomb. Fires it on net. Oh, at the buzzer, a big save. Well, there's the horn, and that means two periods down. And there's still a critical third to play. Looking forward to this one. Third period action is coming up. They are ready to drop the puck on period number three. They're underway here in the third, and this could come down to last shot wins. Well, Pounder, we've played more than 40 minutes now in this one. How do you view things?
Edmonton's got to be better in the third period, no question about it. They've got to be more aggressive on the puck, and they've got to attack the lanes when they get the opportunity. They've had very few shots on net, and they're fortunate this is a close game. If they want to get back in it, they've got to get into the offensive zone. They've got to get net front presence, and they have to shoot at all costs.
McDavid's out there for this shift, guys, and with the team trailing, let's look to him to use his zone ability to try to get some chances here.
Taken by Parayko. And that pass attempt is deflected. On the attack into the offensive end, right up the gut. Denied by the puck stopper. Takes the feed from his netminder. Picked up along the boards by McDavid. There's the whistle, icing the call. Big faceoff looming. Lots of time left in this period. It's been a fun one here tonight. 4-3 hockey game. St. Louis wins possession right off the draw.
Center bears down on that bottom hand. A clean win, and you can see them all setting up, looking to attack the net against this tired group.
Grabbed along the board by Brown. St. Louis takes hold of the puck. Edmonton's playing it from the side. Lugs the puck into the offensive zone corner. Taken along the wall by Kane. And that one's turned away. A chance in front! And that goes off the body and awry. Tries to get the puck over to Letty. Here's a short pass to Kapanen. Great use of the stick of the defensive end by Nurse. Picked up along the wall by Brown. The Blues have it now. St. Louis has shown no signs of slowing down tonight. They continue to lead in the shot department and on the scoreboard in the third. And that shot gets caught in traffic. That knocks him off the puck. Slides it on over to Faulk. Rocks him. And now he passes up to Draisaitl. Strong use of the body to force the puck loose. St. Louis has it in the defensive end. Blaze carrying it ahead. Quick feed to Perana.
Oh, how did he get a glove on that? What a stop by Skinner.
That's a fantastic save by the goaltender, but his team has to do a better job of protecting the middle of the ice. Those high-danger scoring chances eventually go in.
Binnington's got the puck, and he's going to hang on. This is a face. face off, they'll definitely want to win here inside the offensive zone. And with the centers tied up, he swoops in to take possession. Kyrou's got it along the wing. Oh, what a stop with the stick by Skinner.
As a goaltender, you have to be able to read and anticipate the play. He does it perfectly and is able to negate the shot.
Cuts to the front. Too much traffic in the lane. Edmonton's got the puck against the boards. From against the wall, it's centered out. Knocks the puck down with a stick. And a good save on the play as action continues. Gets him a tap with a stick, and the referees don't like it. Here comes the sentence.
End of the game, and you're trailing by one, and you take a penalty. You have to be real aggressive and jump on any opportunity.
And they win the offensive zone faceoff, and here we go. The Blues have it against the wall. Edmonton's got the puck shorthanded. And he takes the feed. St. Louis gains a hold of possession. And now he moves it quickly to Hayes. Poked away and forces the turnover at center. Kulak's got the puck in his own zone. And we are all over with this one tonight. The Blues filled the net often in the first, but then just really kind of played back and defended the rest of the way.